5 seconds to go. Start. Basically, what do we want from our foreign policy? What is the ideal we pursue? Is that ideal divorced from the practical interest of the country, or is it allied with it? As it happens, our ideal and practical interests are the same. No government can afford, however idealistic it may be, to leave or neglect the practical interest of the country. We have believed that freedom is indivisible and peace is indivisible, that economic prosperity is indivisible. And these are the fundamentals on which our foreign policy is based. We have stood for the freedom of all countries, even when we were not free, when we were in no position to help other countries, we went out of our way to give them whatever moral and other support we could. And I know that moral support was welcomed and it did help these countries. Today, we have the same stand. We know that joining together with the Afro-Asian group is not going to immediately strengthen any of the countries who belong to that group. But we know that there is no other way of strengthening them either. We share the common problems, common difficulties, common threats, having stability within our country and by having economic progress. We think we can have stability and progress only if we take a particular economic path, the path of socialism, through which we give social justice to our people. It is the same social justice in the international sphere for which we stand. We believe that while there is poor nations and rich nations, there is bound to be tension. There is not only tension between the poor and the rich, but there is tension among the rich because of their desire to control or to influence the developing nations. This is how in the past most wars took place, and this is the reason for much of the tension today. Yet you find that in spite of this tension, again and again countries try to follow the path which we have advocated, namely the path of conciliation and of trying to solve problems by means of negotiation rather than by war. In my Independence Day speech, I spoke about two recent events. No two countries could have fought more bitterly than the Soviet Union and Germany. Now, foreign policy has to be based on one's historical and geographical background. That is, we see the world from where we are. Other countries see the world from where they are. So, we cannot possibly see it from exactly the same angle. We have certain countries for our neighbors. So, it is important what relationship we have with our neighboring countries. If we are a long way from other countries, we can look at them from different angles. We also find that in the making of the foreign policy of any country and perhaps especially of India, there are certain intangible elements which are just as important or decisive in forming our point of view. It perhaps is easier to pursue foreign policy and fashion our relations with other countries if one is a rich and a powerful nation. Now, India is not a rich or a powerful nation, and we have to keep that in view. It is no use going as we are, but we have made up for our lack of riches and power with some other quality. Earlier, because we were in the forefront of the freedom struggle, that gave us a certain influence. Also because we had leaders of stature who were able to give inspiration to other countries who were in similar position as we were. Today, that situation has changed. All these countries have been free for a number of years. They are all trying to stand on their own feet, and none of them would like to be guided by any other country. They would like to have friends, but they would not like to feel that any one country is superior to them. We ourselves perhaps would not like that position. So we can understand that other countries, and especially countries which are smaller, do not like the position, and we should be very careful that at no time we give an impression that we are wanting to take a leading position. That would immediately mean that we are trying to push them towards a somewhat backward position. So, when we find ourselves in the situation which we're in, that is, in an extremely difficult economic and political situation where you do not have power, then either you have to stand firm on your convictions and try to strengthen yourself, or you strengthen yourself through alliances. As I said earlier, there are people in our country who think that we could ally ourselves with some people, and perhaps that way we would be safer, and I think the feeling of security which one would get could be rather deceiving. Stop.